Good morning. I am Dr. M.V. Jyoti, professor at Raghavendra Institute of Pharmaceutical Education and Research, Anantapuram. Today I am going to demonstrate Rota Evaporator funded by DST SERP to our institute. Organic chemists and natural product researchers very oftenly use this Rota Evaporator to remove non-volatile impurities and also solutes from volatile solvents. Now, let us see the basic principle involved in this Rota Evaporator. It is also known as rotary vacuum evaporator. There are two main basic principles involved in this evaporation. First one is reduced pressure. As we know, as the temperature increases, the rate of evaporation also increases. But by boiling to the higher temperature, the solvent loss may occur and also degradation of the solutes and product may also happen. So to avoid this, we can use Rota Evaporator which can evaporate the solvent under reduced pressure. Reduced pressure generally increases the evaporation lower than the boiling points of the solvent. Then second mechanism or the principle involved in this Rota Evaporator is continuous rotation of the evaporating flask. This is boiling flask or evaporating flask. Throughout this experiment, this rotating flask will be rotated continuously. The rotation here, it exerts a centrifugal force and a frictional force. Centrifugal force exists within the liquid and frictional force exists on the walls of the container. Because of these frictions, it forms a thin layer over the surface of the liquid. So, it increases the surface area of the liquid for evaporation. Then, another benefit of using this Rota Evaporator is nothing but because of the continuous rotation, it avoids the bumping of the liquid. Now, I am going to show you the components of this Rota Evaporator. First one is, this is boiling flask or evaporating flask. To this, we have to transfer the solution which we want to remove solvent from that. Next one is rotating rod to which we have to fix this boiling flask. It also contains a small vent and through which the vapors will pass through and the vapors will be reaching this Dimroth condenser. Dimroth condenser, which is also known as spiral condenser. It is having two connections. One is to the pressure and is another to the water inlet. And next one is water outlet. Then this is the collecting flask. And this is the bath that is in which we can circulate the water. Then this is the vacuum pump. Its capacity is 9 millibars. Next important components of this Rota Evaporator is height adjusting knob. So this is the knob. We have to press it down. And by moving to the right side, we can increase the height of this rotating rod. And by pressing down and moving to the left side, we can reduce the height of this rotating Rota Evaporator height. Then let us see that these are the two switches. One is for RPM, we can see. That is rotations per minute. Generally, we use 100 to 110 RPM for effective evaporation. Then next one is temperature switch. This one. So here, temperature adjusting sensors are also there. So this is to decrease the temperature. And upper one is to increase the temperature. Now we are moving to the experiment procedure. Now I have already prepared the extract is there. Here, this is the solution which is prepared with the methanol solvent of one plant extract. And I am transferring this solution to the flask. Generally, we can fill up to 3/4 of the volume of this flask, not more than 3/4 we should not fill, because it may causes overboiling and also create some pressure inside the flask, and effective evaporation may not take place if we fill up to the rim. So up to 3/4 volume can be filled. Now this boiling flask is to be fixed to the rotating rod. For this, just I am applying a pinch of grease or paraffin wax to avoid the friction between the rotating rod and the flask. At the mouth of the flask, now I am going to apply a pinch of petroleum jelly. Now, just I am taking a pinch of paraffin, liquid paraffin, or even hot paraffin also we can use, just a pinch, and just at the mouth of the flask we have to apply. Now we have to fix to this rotating flask. Then we have to clip this flask . Now let us check this Diemroth condenser for any cleavages or breakages and for the exact circulation of the water. So I am switching the pump. So just we have to check that to ensure the exact correct supply of the water. We have to adjust the height of this evaporator. So we have to submerge this boiling flask into the water. We should not keep very deep down. We have to ensure the level of the water to same as that of the level of the liquid present in the boiling flask. Then we have to switch on that for the adjusting of the rotations per minute, RPM. So here I am adjusting the RPM to 100. So efficient evaporation takes between the 100 to 110, 110 RPM. Then here I have taken methanol as the solvent. So I am taking the temperature 40. Because methanol boiling point is 64.7 degrees centigrade. But since we are doing this experiment under reduced pressure, only 40 degrees temperature is enough to attain the effective evaporation. Now we can see the centrifugal force that is existing within the liquid, and we can see forming a thin layer of the liquid over the surface. So as it forms a thin layer on the surface, that solvent layer will be evaporated and the vapors will reach this here vent and those will be circulated or moving towards the rotating rod and reaches the surface of the condenser, where the vapors will be cooled and condensed, then reaches the distillation flask. So after the adjustments of rotations per minute and temperature to 40 degrees centigrade, here I am putting on the vacuum pump, which has the capability to give 9 millibars of pressure. Now we can see the collection of the cooled solvent and reaches the collecting flask here. It takes 10 to 20 minutes time for complete evaporation of the methanol. In between, I would like to say some information on the selection of the solvents and also to which compounds we can select this rotor evaporator. Here, it is most useful for the evaporation of the solvents like low boiling point solvents like dichloromethane and also acetone, diethyl ether, and the solvents having medium boiling points like methanol, ethanol, ethyl acetate also. Even we can go for the high boiling point solvent removal like n-hexane and also water, dimethyl formamide and DMSO, dimethyl sulfoxide. Since the boiling points of the water and the other high boiling points is more than 100 degrees centigrade, for the effective complete evaporation, we can go for the other methods of evaporation like freeze drying and lyophilization. Here I have used ice to supply cold water to the Dimroth condenser. So the condensation of the vapors occurs very quickly if we use this technique, that is keeping some ice into the water bath. So we should not use this rotor evaporator for the solvent mixers containing ethyl alcohol and peroxides. Also for the unstable compounds like azides and acetylides. Why? Because those will be explosive and also unstable for the high temperatures. And even we should not use for the acetylides and also peroxides and nitro compounds, which are more susceptible for the degradation. See the continuous collection of the condensed vapor in the form of solvent. Here, this is the continuous process. So while doing this, we have to observe for the level of the solvent. We have to wait until the complete evaporation of the solvent. So complete evaporation has taken place and we have collected the total solvent from the mixture. So I am putting off this temperature knob and also the RPM knob. So before removal of that one, we have to relieve the pressure to the volume flask by keeping down this knob. So it relieves the pressure which is there inside the flask. Now we have to remove the clip from this rotating rod. So just increasing the height of this rotor evaporator for safe removal. Then I am taking out this clip. Now I am taking out the collecting flask from the rotating still. This is the solvent recovered from the solution. So like this, even we can use for the synthetic compounds and also for the natural product extracts. Thank you.